ranking every episode of Phineas and Ferb Part 31, Crack That Whip. The Flynn grandparents are watching the kids, so of course they go down to the park to embarrass Candace. Turns out Betty Jo and Jeremy's grandma Hildegard are old skating rivals, so Phineas and Ferb build an arena for a family skating rematch. I adore this rivalry and both of these ladies. Also, I'm coming to realize they build a lot of arenas. Must be their specialty. Whatcha doing six? Ferb is of course the master of skating, even remaining completely calm, ready, and unfazed when Susie tries to mess with him. His line is also the setup for a fun pun. Ferb Zinger 8. Perry mails himself, gets shipped away and back only to end up in his lair. And then Monogram even points out the silliness of it all because he could have just taken the elevator. This is what I'm talking about when it comes to self-aware humor. I love this show. Perry 6. Doof has a splitting headache, and I don't know why this was so funny and weird to me. I think it's just too accurate to real life and hilarious to see such a realistic portrayal in a character like Doofenshmirtz. His head hurts too much for even a flashback. He can't grow facial hair, so he wants to destroy the statue of the incredibly bearded past president Rutherford B. Hayes by turning it into bread and releasing magpies onto it. It's so extra, and I am here for it. Doof 8. Candace has to help her team skate, but worries that if she wins, Jeremy will be mad at her because boys hate to lose to girls. But let's be honest, Jeremy has been challenging gender norms since 2007. Susie is the little evil girl we know and love, and Jeremy is just there to have a good time with his family and Candace, and honestly, it's so cute. Also, I love how Candace is practically unfazed by the stadium turning into bread and just keeps on busting. So busted 8. Overall humor 6. Grandpa Flynn is so hilarious and so pure. The song Ring of Fun is a good time and honestly gives me Beach Boy vibes. But in this show where I have to compare songs that are practically all good, I gotta be hypercritical. So 5. IMDb 8 and I say 6. I think what really shines in this episode are the characters and their great connections and conflicts. Putting it all together, Shrink thinks this episode gets a 65. Putting it between Bad Beard and Eyebrow Bot in 23rd place.